So this is the job of the equippers, not to start ministries, not to even lead churches, but to make disciples who make disciples, who look and act just like Jesus. So in Jesus' name, I speak with authority. I speak with ability to be healed and to be set free and to be liberated in your mind, in your soul, in your heart, in your life, to begin to take steps into the likeness of Jesus, to begin to recognize that you would have wisdom to understand, to grab hold of what is the hope of your calling, together with all the saints, the glory that's been placed in you, the spirit and authority that's been placed in you, to begin to walk into your city with one or more, and to begin to destroy the works of darkness, begin to release people from the captivity of their minds, from the deceit of the devil, from doctrines of men, that you can speak truth that goes between their spirit and their soul, that they could be set free and walk in the same ability, the same authority that Jesus walked in himself when he was in the earth. And this is the pattern that must continue. This is the direction that we take on purpose. This is the principle that we obey. This is all the commands of Jesus are wrapped up in these things, walking into this path. This is what we must do, and we will have no return of Christ until we do these things. Who knows? Maybe Jesus could even return in our generation, but not until we have the saints being equipped unto the unity of the faith, the saints being equipped unto the measure of the stature of his fullness, the saints being equipped until we stop flowing around like chickens with our heads cut off. Every wind of doctrine, every new thing, every new teacher, every new church, our city here in Joplin, that's what it's known for. You get a new church and everybody flocks to it until they get offended, until that guy screws up, or until they're like, well, I'm bored now, let's go to another church. Every 3 or 4 years, a new church pops up and they all flock to it. It's just a bunch of kids running around the playground seeing who's popular. That will never change the world. It has never changed the world. In fact, the way that church has been done in the last 300 or 400 years is never going to change the world. It is the gospel of the kingdom which produces people, the sons of God, who walk with the outward manifestation of Jesus in the earth. Dead people getting up is what we need. Cancer cases being eradicated from your city is what we need. Fibromyalgia and traumatic injuries being healed instantly is what we need. And we need people who take responsibility to do these things and to train others to do it. Average, ordinary, everyday people who have been sitting in a pew for far too long, until they take responsibility, until we all take responsibility for this kind of maturity, we will have no change. We will be subject to the news, we'll be subject to lies of the enemy, and we'll be subject to the doctrines of men. Until Christ be formed in you, we will have the same thing. We'll have waves of hell spewing COVID and all its variants and cringing at the thought of, oh, what if we die? Listen, you are the master of death, so take dominion over it in your city in Jesus' name.